Hello students, now in the last video we discussed the limiting reagent. Now let us discuss the oxidation number concept. This is a very important topic because after this concept we have the some few concepts, that is balancing of ionic equations. So for that we need the this concept. You should be very clear with about these concepts. Okay, now let us discuss the oxidation number concept. So here it is, how can you define the oxidation number? It is the number of electric charge present on an atom of element. Means what are the charges present in element, that is called as a oxidation number. So here for hydrogen H+, +1 is the oxidation number. For here oxygen O-2 is the oxidation number. Here we have the nitrogen, that is N2 will come, okay. For here O -1 by 2 means here the oxidation number, okay. So oxidation number, here if you see, if we are talking about the number, okay, that number, okay, this oxidation number may be positive, integer, or negative, or zero, sometimes fractional values also will be there, okay. So there may be positive, negative, integer, some fraction values also will be there for the oxidation number, okay. Now here we have the rules, okay, rules for calculation of oxidation number. These are very important. You have to remember all the rules. Now let us discuss the rules one by one. First rule is what? In elementary state. Elementary state means what? Self-combining state. Okay. Means elements, you know very well. All the atoms of similar atoms going to combine give the what? Element. Okay. In elementary state, the oxidation number of an atom is zero. What is the, let us see the example. Here we have the H2. Okay. H2 means what? Hydrogen atoms are fused and give the H2, okay. So it is what? Self-combining state. Now oxidation number of hydrogen in this one, 0. Now if you see the P2, oxidation number of phosphorus in this one, 0. Why? Because means all we have the phosphorus atoms only. Next, if you see the P4, here also what? The oxidation number of phosphorus in this is 0. Why? Because means we have the similar phosphorus atoms. Next, aluminium also, if you see that in the elementary state, aluminium oxidation number is what? 0. So, in self-combining state, oxidation number is what? 0. This is first rule. Next, second one is what? In combined state, okay? In combined state, if you say in that, oxidation number of first group elements is what? Equal to +1, okay? If you see the first group elements, what are the first group elements? We have the lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium, okay? So for this, general oxidation number is +1. Already we discussed in the classification of elements, okay. Why? Because means they have the extra electron. If lost this one electron, they are going to get the octet configuration. Next, oxidation number of second group elements. What are they? Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium. Okay, for this we have the common oxidation number is what? +2, okay. So why? Because means they have the excess 2 electron to get the octet configuration. So, noble gas configuration, sorry, not octet, this is noble gas configuration. So, this is general oxidation state is what? +2. Oxidation number of 17th group elements, okay, nothing but halogens. That is general oxidation number of what? Here we have the -1. Why? Because means to get the noble gas configuration, they have one electron is less, they are going to get. So, here general oxidation state is what? -1. So what are the elements? We have fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, okay. Astatine is the radioactive elements. We are not going to discuss about that one. Next, if you see the next in the B, in second we have the B in combined state. General oxidation number of hydrogen one generally +1. But here we have the exception cases that you have to remember in metal hydrides, okay. Metal hydrides means what? Metal combining with the hydrogen is called as metal hydrides. For example, we have the sodium hydride, calcium hydride, magnesium hydride, and this NaBH4 is called as a sodium borohydride. LiAlH4 is called as a what? Lithium aluminium hydride. So all these are the metal hydrides. In these, hydrogen oxidation number is what? -1. Very important. Why? Because means oxidation number depends on the electronegativity. Here metal having the less electronegativity, hydrogen having the more electronegativity. So what happened? It will pull the electron towards it. So definitely it's going to get the negative charge. Now metal going to get the positive charge. So general oxidation number of hydrogen is +1. Whereas in case of metal hydrides, the oxidation number is what? -1. Exception cases you have to remember. Next, if you see general oxidation number of oxygen is what? Minus 2. Okay. But again here we have the few exception cases. What are the exception cases means? Here, if you see in peroxides, what are the peroxides we have? Hydrogen peroxide, H2O2, barium peroxide, sodium peroxide. In all these cases, oxidation number of oxygen is what? Minus 1. Okay. So, general oxidation state is minus 2. But in peroxide, oxidation state of oxygen is what? Minus 1. Next, if you see the superoxides, here example we have the potassium superoxide. In that, oxygen oxidation state is what? Here, oxygen state is minus 1 by 2. Next, if you see another example, in O2F2, oxidation number of oxygen here what? Plus 1. Generally, up to now we saw the minus in negative value. But here, in this case, in O2F2, we have the oxidation number of oxygen what? Plus 1. Why? Because mean in oxygen, fluorine having the more electronegativity compared to oxygen. So, oxygen going to lose electron, fluorine going to get the electron. So, because of that reason, oxygen having the oxidation number is what? Plus 1. In next, if you see next example, in OF2, oxidation number of oxygen what? Here we have the plus 2. Okay, these all exception cases you have to remember. Next, if you come to see the third rule, in a polyatomic ion, the sum of oxidation number of all atom is equal to its charge. What is the meaning of that one? Okay, for example, we have the, this is a polyatomic ion. Polyatomic ion means what? We have so many atoms are there having the charge. That type of molecules are called as what? Polyatomic ion. Okay, here we have the sulfate, here we have the phosphate. So in this what happened, if you see, the sum of the oxidation number of all the atoms is equal to its charge. Means what? Here we have the sulfur oxidation state. You have to calculate for sulfur. One sulfur atom is a 7 sulfur plus. Here with the 4 oxygen atoms. Okay. 4 into oxygen atoms. This is oxygen atoms equal to the sum of these. All the oxidation state is equal to its charge. How much charge we have? Minus 2. Okay. Now if you see here, next to phosphate ion. One phosphorus atom is there plus 4 into 4 oxygen atoms. Okay, here we have the 4 oxygen atoms is equal to here sum of the oxidation number of all the atoms equal to what? Here we have the charge. How much we have? Minus 3. So minus 3. Okay. Next, fourth, in a neutral molecule, if the molecule is neutral, then the sum of the oxidation number of all atom is equal to 0. What is the meaning of that one? Okay. So here we have the potassium permanganate KMnO4. Okay, in this case you are going to make the sum of the all the oxidation number you are taking as about 0. Here for one potassium is there plus one manganese is there plus 4 oxygen atoms are there. 4 oxygen atoms equal to, you are going to make equal what? 0. Okay, in case of ions you are making the, that is equal to particular charge. Here we have the minus 2 minus 2. Here equal to, you are making the what? The charge is minus 3. But when the case of neutral molecule, here KMnO4 is a neutral molecule. Why? Because means we don't have any charge on that. So in that case, that is the, you have to make the what? Sum of the oxidation number is equal to 0. Okay. Next, the maximum oxidation number of atoms should not exceed behind the group number. This is in case of what? Particularly, I am talking about the S and P block elements. Okay, make it correction in the notes. In S and P block elements. That too in Roman numerical system. Okay, what is that one? Again I will discuss with the examples. So very very important in case of S and P block elements. Okay, in S and P block elements, the maximum oxidation number of atoms should not exceed, okay, we should not go what? Above the group number. That too we are talking the group number, but in Roman numerical system, not the Arabic system. Okay, so now let us see the examples. Okay, first example, if you see here, we have so many examples are there. Okay, a few of them I will discuss, remaining you have to work out in the notes. Now in KMnO4, what is the manganese oxidation number? I ask. Okay, Mn here, what is the oxidation number of manganese? Okay, so whatever you need, you are assuming as that is X. Okay, here we have the potassium general oxidation state, it is a group 1, so general oxidation state is what? Plus 1. Here manganese we have to find out, so I am writing as it is X plus 4 into minus 2. Minus 2 by, because means already we discussed oxygen general oxidation state is what? Minus 2. We are going to sum of the all the oxidation number is equal to 0. Why? Because means it is a neutral molecule. Now if you go for the simplification, x is x minus 7y because means minus 8 plus 1 means minus 7 equal to 0, x equal to plus 7. So here what, this is the oxidation number of manganese in KMnO4, how much? Plus 7. Okay. Next, if you see second example, ClO4 minus, in this what is the chlorine oxidation number? So what are going to, you are going to find out that you have to assume as a x. Now chlorine we want, so I am assuming as about x plus 4 into minus 2. Why? Because means oxygen general oxidation state is what? Minus 2. 4 into minus 2 equal to minus 1. Why? Because means we have here third rule, what happened in polyatomic ion, the sum of the oxidation number of all the atom is equal to what? It's a charge. So now here it is a ion, so we are going to make the sum of the all the oxidation number equal to minus 1. Now x, if you go for the simplification, x 4 into minus 2 means minus 8 equal to minus 1. So you are getting the chlorine oxidation number how much here? Plus 7 in the ClO4 minus. Okay. Next, if you go for the ammonium ion in NH, if I ask in NH4 plus, what is the oxidation number of nitrogen here? What is the nitrogen oxidation number I ask? So nitrogen we have to find plus 4 into plus 1. Why? Because means general oxidation state of hydrogen is what? Plus 1. Equal to, you are going to make what? Plus 1. Why? Because means already we discussed, in case of polyatomic ion, the sum of the oxidation number should be equal to what? Plus 1. Now if you go for the simplification, n equal to here plus 1, this is become what? Minus 4. So n equal to what? Minus 3 is the oxidation number in case of ammonium ion. Okay. Now you see the next example, we have here complex is there. This question already you came across in the what? Classification of elements. Okay. Now here they ask what is the aluminium oxidation number. So for that what happened, you have to go for the sum of the all the oxidation number is equal to charge. Now aluminium we have to find, then how many atoms are there, let us go for first go for the atoms, then after that we will substitute the oxidation number. We have the one aluminium atom is there, one chlorine, and plus 5 water molecules are there. Okay. That I am making that all the oxidation number should be equal to what? Plus 2 according to our rule. Now if you see aluminium we have to find, already we discussed chlorine belongs to 17th group, then oxidation state is what? Minus 1 plus 5 into, I am substituting here 0. Why? Because 0, this means if you go for the H2O, here we have the 2 hydrogen atoms plus 1 oxygen atom. So if you see the oxidation number equal to 0. Why? Because means it is a neutral atom. Now in a hydrogen, general oxidation number is what? Plus 1. Okay. So oxygen is minus 2. So if you go for some, how much we are getting here? 0. So in a general total oxidation number of H2O is what? Here 0. So directly I am going to substitute 5 into 0 equal to plus 2. Now if you go for simplification, aluminium is good. Aluminium, how much we are getting the oxidation number here? We are getting the plus 3. Okay. Now if you go for the next example, I am taking the randomly here, in Fe2O3, what is the iron oxidation number? Okay, all these examples are present in the test book. Okay, in in-text, if you see the in-text questions along with the back set of test book questions, all these questions are there. Okay, I am not giving any extra examples. Now, if you see in this Fe2O3, what is iron oxidation number means? Same here. Let us see how many atoms are there. We have the 2 iron atoms plus 3 oxygen atoms. That I am total oxidation number I am making as a equal to 0. Why? Because means it is a neutral molecule. For neutral molecule, sum of the oxidation number should be equal to 0. Now we have to find the iron. Okay, 2 iron atom plus 3 into minus 2. Why? Because means oxygen general oxidation state is what? Minus 2 is equal to 0. Now if you go for the simplification, 2 iron atoms, 3 into minus 2 minus 6 equal to 0. So 2 iron atom equal to plus 6. Now for 1 iron atom, how much means? Plus 6 divided by 2. Okay, nothing but plus 3. Here, you have to remember, always we will calculate the oxidation number for 1 iron atom. Okay, per atom you have to calculate. This is very very important. Always we will calculate the oxidation number per an atom. Okay, here for 2 iron atom we have the plus 6. But for 1 iron atom, how much here? Plus 3. So, in this iron oxidation state is how much? We have the plus 3. Okay. Next, if you go for another example, I am talking about the potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7. In that, someone asks what is the chromium oxidation number. Now, let us see here, we have the 2 potassium plus 2 chromium plus 7 oxygen atoms. the total sum of the oxidation number, we are going to make what? 0. Why? Because means it's a neutral molecule. Now let us see, potassium general oxidation state is what? Plus 1. Chromium we have to find out, 2 chromium atom plus 7 into minus 2. Why? Because means oxygen general oxidation state is what? Minus 2 equal to 0. Now if you go for simplification, for 2 chromium atom equal to plus 2, equal to plus 12, sorry, plus 12. But here what happened? For 1 chromium atom plus 12 divided by 2 equal to plus 6. Means for 1 chromium atom oxidation number how much? We have the plus 6, okay? Like that you have to calculate. Here we have the Al2O3 also there for aluminium oxide, you have to work out. Next, here we have one question. In F2O3I2, okay, what is the oxidation number of fluorine, oxygen and I2 respectively, okay? Now if you see, for all this case, you have oxidation number is what? 0. Why? Because means self-combining state, oxidation number is 0. The answer is what? 0. Why? Because means in self-combining state, oxidation number is 0. Already we discussed in that, this is the first rule, okay? Next, if you see the ion, sixth rule, if you see the ions composed of only one atom, okay, one atom, the oxidation number is equal to the charge on the ion. Means what? For example, I have the ion in that consists of only one atom, that is what? Magnesium plus 2. In this, what is the oxidation number? Means plus 2. Here we have the single atom, okay, in that we have the minus 1 charges there. So for chloride ion, what is the oxidation number? Means minus 1. Now in case of sodium Na plus means here we have the single atom, what is the oxidation number? Means here plus 1. In case of potassium plus, okay, in this all the oxidation number means plus 1. We have the fluoride ion F minus, okay, now what is the oxidation number? Means minus 1, okay. So the ion composed of only one atom, if ion consists of only one atom, means in this case the oxidation number is equal to what? Charge on the ion, okay. Next, here we have the few examples you have to work out, okay. All this we have the examples in the notes given, you have to work out. Now let us see the next, the examples for the one. Here we have the hydrocarbons. Now how we have to find out the oxidation state in the hydrocarbons? Now if you see the methane, okay, methane structure of methane will be like this. If you go for the carbon has to follow the valency, tetravalency, nothing but 4 bonds should be there around the each carbon. Now here what happened, if you write here, this is the structure of methane, if you write for simplification, so general oxidation state of hydrogen is what? Plus 1. Here also plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. These 4 positive charge will be balanced by the what? Carbon, that is minus 4. You are going to get the oxidation number is what? Minus 4. Why? Because means now hydrogen going to lose the electron, this each hydrogen going to lose the electron. So R are getting the plus 1. So these 4 positive 4 electrons are going to get by whom? Carbon. So this is now carbon going to get the minus 4. So carbon oxidation state in the methane what? Minus 4. Now I am going for the next example. Here you can see we have the ethene, okay. Now ethene, if you see the what is the oxidation number of each carbon, means again you have to write the structure clearly. So now if you see hydrogen in carbon, who is going to lose electron? Hydrogen. Why? Because means it having the less electronegativity, carbon having the more electronegativity. So it is going to lose one electron, this hydrogen also going to lose the one electron. These 2 electrons are going to get by the whom? Carbon. So it is going to get the oxidation number what? Minus 2, and hydrogen going to get the plus 1, plus 1. Now here you have to remember carbon are the same element, so there is no transfer of electrons. So here you should not consider. Why? Because means both have the similar atoms, that is the carbons. Now in this carbon what happens? Same thing, we have the 2 hydrogen atoms are there, so hydrogen going to lose electron, carbon going to get the electron, so it's going to lose the one electron, this hydrogen also going to lose the one electron. So you are going to get the how many electrons are going to get gained by the carbon? Here minus 2 electrons. So no oxidation number of carbon, this carbon what? Minus 2. Like this you can see the ethane also, okay. Now benzene, if you come to see the benzene, this is structure of benzene, okay. The formula is what? C6H6. In this, if you see in this structure, we have the 6 carbon atoms and 6 hydrogen atoms are there, okay. Now if you see what is the carbon oxidation number in benzene, means we have the 6 carbons, in 6 carbon also oxidation number is minus 1 only. How? Because means how here what happened? Hydrogen going to lose electron, carbon going to get the electron. So here plus 1, minus 1. In between these 2, there is no transfer of electron. Why? Because means both having the similar atoms, electronegativity will be same. So now in between these two, carbon going to get the electron, is going to lose the electron. So plus 1, minus 1. So like this, you have to see the oxidation number in case of hydrocarbons. Okay. Next here in that in-text question, we have some question. If you refer the question number 82, and that too in the we have the C and D question. They ask what is the oxidation number of each carbon in ethanol and ethanoic acid. Okay. So before that, you should be write clearly the structure. Okay. If you see the structure here, we have the this is structure of ethanol. Okay. Now I am going to see the what the oxidation number of this carbon. Now if you see that this carbon here, this carbon to this carbon, same electronegativity. So we are not going to see here. Now see if this carbon here one hydrogen is there plus one, this hydrogen plus one plus one. So these three electrons are going to get by this carbon atom. So now carbon going to get the minus 3 oxidation number. Now if you see that this carbon, what happened here, we have the OH group. Okay, in this OH group, general carbon oxidation number is what? Oxygen oxidation number is what? Minus 2. So here if you assume minus 2, now he is going to get the plus 1. So minus 2 plus 1 mean net how much will left to minus 1 here. Okay, this is minus 1. Here we have the 2 plus 1 charges. So this plus 1, minus 1 going to be get cancelled. We left with the only one minus 1. Why? Because means one electron is left. So now what is the oxidation number here? Minus 1. Okay. So this is the So what we are going to do, this is total OH hydroxy group is there. General oxidation number of oxygen is what? Minus 2. But here minus 2 plus 1 means how much we left here net? Minus 1. Okay. Here if you see, we have the two hydrogen atoms are there, plus 1, plus 1. In that one plus 1 going to be get cancelled with the minus 1. So left with the only one plus 1. This one plus 1 going to balance with the what? One negative charge on the this carbon. So carbon oxidation number for this carbon is how much? Minus 1. Now if you see the next ethanoic acid, R is also known as a acetic acid. Now this is structure of ethanoic acid. Now let us see this carbon. This carbon means around we have the 3 hydrogen atoms are there. So general oxidation state of hydrogen is what? Plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. So this total 3 plus charges are balanced with the minus 3 on the this carbon atom. So this carbon oxidation number of here how much? Minus 3. Now come to if you see here, this carbon also this carbon plus 3. Why? Because means here total if you see plus 1 minus general oxidation state of oxygen what? Minus 2. But net how much we left? Minus 1. Okay. Here oxygen only we have, so minus 2. So minus 2 minus 1. Total of how much we have? Minus 3. This minus 3 will be balanced by what? Plus 3 and this carbon. So here carbon oxidation number how much? We have the plus 3. Okay. So like this we have the few examples we have to work out. Now let us see some exception cases. Okay. Now exception cases we have the, this is calcium. Here we have the peroxide. Okay. Already we discussed in peroxide, oxygen having the minus 1 oxidation state. Let us see how it is. Okay. Here if I ask what is the oxidation number of oxygen in the calcium peroxide. So you have to find out for the oxygen. Now we have the one calcium atom plus two oxygen atoms, that is equal to 0. Why? Because mean if the molecule is 0, sum of the oxidation number should equal to 0. Now calcium second group, so general oxidation state is what? Plus 2. Plus 2 into two oxygen atoms equal to 0. We have to find out the two oxygen atoms equal to here plus 2. If it's come this side, it's minus 2. So oxygen state how much? We have the minus 1. So it is what? In peroxide, oxygen oxidation number equal to what? Minus 1. Next, we have the next example, sodium borohydride. Exception case important. Last year, MD3 question also this one. So, what is the given here? Note in, one you have to remember, in sodium borohydride, hydrogen having the what? Minus 1 oxidation state. Okay. Already we discussed in metal hydrides, instead of hydrogen having the plus 1 oxidation state, it having the minus 1 oxidation state. Okay, so here in so now come to calculate the what is the oxidation number of boron. So here we have the let us see the all the how many atoms are there, one sodium, one boron, four hydrogens equal to 0. Why? Because means neutral molecule, sum of the oxidation number should be equal to 0. Now sodium first group element, so general oxidation state is plus 1. Boron we have to find out plus 4 into minus 1. Here up to now we took the hydrogen as a plus 1, but in case of metal hydrides. So here we have to take the minus 1. Minus 1 equal to 0. So boron minus 3 equal to 0. Find out getting the one boron equal to plus 3. Okay, this is the boron oxidation state in the sodium borohydride. Now let us see the here one more exception, H2SO5. Okay, if you go for general according to formula, here what happened, let us see. If I ask what is sulfur oxidation state means, we have the 2 hydrogen plus sulfur plus 5 into minus 2. Here I am taking the oxidation state of oxygen, how much? Here minus 2 equal to 0. So if you go for simplification, we are getting the sulfur equal to plus 8. But here it is a wrong. Why? Because means important in S and P block elements, oxidation number should not exceed the group number. Now here what happened? We got the plus 8, but it belongs to what? 6th group. I am talking about the in Roman numerical system, it belongs to 6th group. So the maximum oxidation number is what? It should be plus 6, but here we got the plus 8. So how we have to calculate? For that you have to see the structure. In the structure we have the peroxy linkage. What is a peroxy linkage means? If OO having the single bond like this, this type of linkage is called as a what? Peroxy linkage. Okay. Now if you see the structure here, this is structure of H2SO5. In this, if you see here, I am asking about the what is sulfur oxidation number. Okay. Now here we have the plus 1, here oxygen generally minus 2, but minus 2 plus 1 means how much we left here? Net how much we left? Minus 1. Okay. Now in this case what happened? Hydrogen having the plus 1 here. Now minus 1 will be there on the oxygen. Generally we have the minus 2, but in the peroxy linkage we have the minus 1. Okay. Now here minus 1 is there. Here oxygen with double bond means we have the minus 2. Here oxygen both the sides single bond means minus 1. But oxygen with double bond means minus 2. Here minus 2. So total if you see the sulfur around, how much negative charge is there? Minus 2, minus 2, minus 1, minus 1, total minus 6 is there. This minus 6 will be balanced with the what? Plus 6. So in H2SO5 sulfur oxidation is what? We have the plus 6. Okay. These are the few examples for the oxidation state. You have to remember all the things. Next, if you see the other examples, okay, you can see in the notes also. So here also we have the some exception cases, that is H2SO4O6. Generally, if you go for the calculation according to that, we are getting the sulfur equal to 2.5. This is what? Fractional oxidation state. But if I ask exactly what is the oxidation state of each sulfur means, you have to draw the structure, okay? This is the structure of H2S4O6, okay? In this, if you see the structure, around if you see this hydrogen is plus 1, oxygen is minus 1. Why? Because means generally minus 2 plus 1 means we left with the minus 1. Now, if you see here, oxygen with the double bond O means oxidation number how much? Minus 2. Here also minus 2. Here there is no transfer of electron because electron rate is same. So sulfur is not there. Okay, now so here in here also sulfur both are similar atoms. So 0. Here oxidation number is what? 0. Here also 0. Now if you see, so if you now see this sulfur atoms around us, how much negative charge is there? Here minus 2, minus 2, minus 1. So we have the minus 5 negative charge. This is going to balance with the what? Plus 5 positive charge and the sulfur. Okay. After that, here what happened? Both are similar. There is no transfer of electrons. Here also no transfer of electrons. So this sulfur oxygen state is 0. This sulfur also 0. Now come to this sulfur. Around this we have the same. Here we have the minus 5 negative charge. This minus 5 negative charge going to balance with the plus 5. So here we have the 3 types of oxidation state. For this sulfur we have the plus 5. This sulfur 0, 0. For this sulfur we have the plus 5. So this is what, this is we have the fractional oxidation state. Okay, this is about the oxidation state. You have to work out more. Next here also we can see the potash alum. Okay, in potash alum, what is the potash alum means? Potassium sulfate, aluminium sulfate into 24H2O, it is called as a potash alum. Okay, this also we have the back side of academic textbook question. In this, potassium oxidation number is plus 1 and aluminium is plus 3. Okay, how it is, you have to work out. Just to do the workout, all the examples are present in the test book. Now here you can see the in representative elements maximum oxidation state is equal to group number. Here you can see we have the group and element, first A, second A, third A. I am taking the word representative elements. Representative elements means what? S and P black elements together called as the what? Representative elements. So first A, second A, S black elements. 3rd A, 4th A, 5th A, 6th A, 7th A. Okay. here 6th and 7th, and this is a 17th group. Okay, you have to take the 17th group and 7th A. So here in this case, if you see element, we have some examples. Here you can see the higher oxidation number of element. Okay, higher oxidation number for 1st A we have the plus 1, for 2nd A plus 2, for 3rd A we have the plus 3, for 4th A we have the plus 4, for 5th A plus 5, and for 6th A plus 6, for 7th A plus 7. So important here, noble gas oxidation number is 0. Why? Because means these are the only we have the monoatomic. So for the atom, that's the noble gas oxidation number is what? 0. Okay, so this is the very important higher oxidation number for the represented elements equal to group number. Here group number we took the what? Roman numerical system. So Roman numerical system is equal to maximum group number. So if you see the 5th group A, what is the maximum oxidation number means? Plus 5. Okay, very important.